Hi folks, my name is Mario Peach with the TiddlyWiki 5.0.15 beta. There was a new documentation tiddler that invites users to improve the TiddlyWiki documentation. So you can see it here, improving the TiddlyWiki documentation. There are 10 steps that describes how it works. The very first step is go to edit mode. Here we can see the new banner with the link that says find out how, which is this tiddler, and then there is a link to the GitHub repository where you have the possibility to edit the content of the tiddler with the web UI, so there is no need to install any software or things like this, so it can be directly done with GitHub. The only thing you need is a GitHub account. But okay, let's click it. If you have an account, it says okay, sign in. GitHub knows me already, so I just sign in with my username and my password. And if you don't have an account, you can create one. So I say sign in. Okay, then I'm at the Tiddler, at the Jeremy's repository, TiddlyWiki 5 from Jermolin. Then there is some information that tells you about what happens next. So when you send the file to GitHub, then they are forking the project, which just means they duplicate the project into your account where you have write access, because with Jeremy's access, with Jeremy's repository, you don't have any write access. Okay, there are some adjustments with TiddlyWiki. The indentation should be with tabs and four. No wrap is just for readability. So if I say soft wrap, I can read everything in, which is normally in one line. Here it now is with two lines, wrap and no wrap. So you have to scroll here. So I prefer soft wrap. Then I can add my contents. So there will be a short video soon. Okay, that's basically it. Then I say propose file changes. I can include some information for the pull request here, but I leave it blank the moment I say propose file changes. In normal cases, update improving this tiddler. There you have the possibility for some more explanations, so why you think it is important to change it in that way. There should be something useful. I say propose file changes. With my account, because I already have a Pimario TiddlyWiki account, it creates a feature branch. So with GitHub, this is called a feature branch. So I'm working from Jeremy's master branch, and for me it creates a new feature branch which is called patch 1. Now I can say okay, update improve documentation. Here I say this is just a test, so don't merge. So this is some information for Jeremy. What else can be seen? So here there is some tests. This is important for Jeremy, so it is possible to merge it without any conflicts. Then I can say create the pull request. What else do I see? I see what's the difference between Jeremy's version and my version. So in this case, it's this one commit. There is one file changed, and this is the information that actually is changed. So with my repository, it creates a patch branch. And now I can say create pull request. Okay, now it creates a new issue. Now we are back at Jeremy's repository, and here it creates a pull request with the information I just typed in. Then there is also the information what's changed, so Jeremy can see this information. Then there is the conversation, so he can comment here, or I can comment, everyone else can comment with this. Okay, so what's in the files? And as you can see, there is a typo, so I said video. Okay, how can I change it? I go back to my repository, I have the repositories tiliwiki5, my repository, go to editions, tiliwiki5.com, tiddlers. I know the branch which is called how-tos, and it's improve the tiliwiki documentation. Oops, where is it? I'm at the master branch, so I need to go to my patch 1. Now I see the patch 1, there is my text, because Jeremy didn't merge it, so but I have the possibility to edit it again and say okay, there will be a short video soon. Okay, I say commit the changes, and that's it. So the changes are committed. Now let's go back to Jeremy's repository and go back to my pull requests. So there are the issues and the pull requests. I have pull requests, then I have the possibility to filter the pull requests, but this one is mine, so it says okay, there's possibility for author, so I could filter it a little bit more. So these are my pull requests. Click it, and now I can see that there are two commits. So it just edit the information, so there is still one file changed, but now with the typo fixed. So this is a possibility. So if you find out that you made some errors or something like this, just go back to your repository and add as many commits as you like. Then there is also the conversation. So if Jeremy doesn't like some things, you can always change it, commit it, and then there is the possibility that everything is merged together. So that's basically it. Relatively simple steps. Just go to the edit mode, go click this tiddler, start editing, click the button and follow the steps. Yeah, there is one thing, change the tabs to 4, something like this. Yeah, that's basically it. This is the first video. There will be a second one which shows you how to edit the stuff without going to Jeremy's repository, but do it with your own. It's a little bit different, but basically this is the preferred way at the moment. Yeah, that's it, and I hope you like it. Have fun.